Okay, so we're going to do a rundown on the 3.9 ton GVM kit. Now, our 3.9 ton GVM kit is suitable for 79 series dual cab and single cab, 76 series wagon, and 78 series troop carrier. Now, these kits are legal in every state of Australia, pre and post rego. So now what you get in our 3.9 ton kit is a 3.9 ton GVM, a 3.5 ton tow capacity, so you maintain tow capacity, there's no sacrifice on that, and a 7400 GCM. Now, probably one of the biggest things that you get where you won't get anywhere else is you get a 2700 kilo rear axle load capacity. So as we load these cars, once you put people in the car, all your luggage goes in the back or it goes on your tow bar. So axle load capacities become critical to get the use out of your GVM. There's no point saying I've got a 3.9 ton GVM, but I can't practically load the vehicle and maintain rear axle load capacity. So they're sort of the things that we're finding. Now, the other one is GVMs, GCMs, etc. You cannot go putting large GVMs and GCMs, etc. on vehicles that you're just throwing springs and shocks at. You have to be doing more than that. So in the Jmacx system, to get what we're asking, what we're doing is we're providing the bolt-in coil conversion. Now, this is a cradle engineered and designed and tested to spread the load, strengthen the chassis. It's a welded, patented design. So this is not a bolt-in kit where we've got bolts and plates and brackets and it's like a Meccano set. As a chassis goes through its motions, it will twist and flex. So anything that's a pieces that's all bolted together will constantly need checking to see if the components are tight over time. Once this conversion is bolted into the car, it never requires rechecking again. So it's bolted through a three axis point. It's got taper locks that lock the cradle into place. So once it's fitted, that's it. There's no way that this thing can come loose, fall out, or have any issues like that. So what you get is your coil conversion system. You get the rated GVM springs, rated GVM shocks, that's front and rear. You also get adjustable upper and lower control arms. Now these are solid heavy duty items and they're fully adjustable. The big thing with our Jmacx suspension is everything's adjustable, so you can fine tune that vehicle to drive at its absolute best. Adjustable rear Panhard, all standard in the kit. Poly spacers to, poly inserts to insulate your coil from your cradle. You get frame bolts, control arm bolts. You get brake prop valve bolts or a plate, which is for your early models, or if you've got a DPF model, you get the twin line kit, which is part of it, or a single line for non-DPF. Sway bar block kit, so to space your front sway bar down to suit a 2 inches of lift. You get Panhard bolts, frame locators, handbrake tabs, brake line kit. You also get your brake lines for the rear of your differential. You get the Jmacx upgraded differential, so the fabricated differential, which corrects the track and obviously gives you that high axle load rating. EN26 chrome moly axles. Now, you can option these to 300M for a couple of hundred bucks, but the reality of it is if you ever come to the path where you're gonna break that, you usually will blow your center to pieces. So I would rather break an axle than blow my whole center and everything to pieces. Ideally, you've got to have a sacrificial part. It just becomes what's the part in the chain that's going to break. Now, the other thing that it comes with is a sway bar. So rear sway bar for the kit. Brake booster, so 30% increase in braking. So that's part of it as well. So now the options, airbags are also part of your options. So either an airbag man or a polyair option. So that's all standard in that 2-inch kit. Now, this kit can also be optioned up to 4 inches. So 3 or 4 inches of lift and 35 inch tires. So to option this up from that, you have to then go from an offset bush in your standard radius arm, which is part of that 3.9 kit as a standard. You need to option up to radius arms. Now the Jmacx billet radius arms, they are the best radius arm on the market anywhere in the world. Go to our product review video and we'll go into a bit more depth with those. So we run those. You have the option of running your standard genuine bushes, which are a very good bush, or you can opt up to our new polyelast. There's also a product review on that as well. So check that out and that'll give you the difference between genuine and the polyelast. When you step up over 50 millilift, you need brake lines, so longer brake lines. Now, we have the braided line kit, so these will give you more braking pressure as well. The other option is legal 35-inch tyres, pre and post rego every state on vehicles with 4 inches of lift. We do speedo correction, so we can correct that speedo to meet the legal requirement. The other one is front adjustable Panhard. So once you start lifting that vehicle, we need to bring that front end into alignment. Now, once you step over your foam cell pro shock, these things have been an absolutely outstanding shock and have outperformed a lot of other shocks on the market, specifically for the use that we're using them for. We're talking about load carrying vehicles, change to coil springs, etc. So very good. So if you want to option up, you can go to our King shock range. Now, these King shocks are unlike anything else available in Australia. They are custom built specifically for us by Kings in the US via King Shocks Australia. They have built-in bump zones. So, you know, you hit washouts or something you don't see, these things will increase in pressure in the end to reduce that impact on your chassis to stop you doing any damage. So they're an option that you can jump up to as well. So in Australia, 2 inches to 4 inches, 3.9 ton GVM, we will go into the discussion on our basic coil conversion video as to why we use a five link system and nothing else. Because what we do at Jmacx is we produce touring load carrying vehicles that have excellent safety, stability and handling. They have awesome off-road ability, but obviously the heavier the GVM that you go, the more load that you will be required to have to make that car flex like it, you know, like if you want something that's going to flex. These things will flex really, really well, but at 3.9 ton, you'll end up with about, you know, 15 to 20 pound in your airbags, and that car will sit nice. So it's a very good all-round package. Picking the biggest GVM that's available is not the answer for everybody. So these GVMs are built specifically for people that are just, I've got a weekender or a tourer or a vehicle that I use for work. You don't need to carry 400 to 600 kilos of constant weight to make this the perfect package. So we'll go from this package into a heavier packages in our basic conversion. So check out all of our product videos as we go and we can get more depth into what our GVM requirement is and also too what's going to work for your vehicle.